So with the Pixel Buds 2A, the first thing we came with is active noise cancellation, addressing their top need. And it's not just checkbox active noise cancellation. It's really delivering pro-level active noise cancellation to our users.
Welcome to the Made by Google podcast, where we meet the people who work on the Google products you love. Here's your host, Rachid Finge.
Vanessa Pau is the product manager of the brand new Pixel Buds 2A. How do you improve battery life, sound quality, and add active noise cancellation all in one go? Vanessa is here to tell us all about it.
This is the Made by Google podcast.
Vanessa, you hold a degree in biomedical engineering. So if I told you back then that you'd be working on wireless earbuds today, what would you have said?
I guess not out of the realm of impossibility. That's true. I do have a background in biomedical engineering. I joined Google actually through Verily, which was a sister company to Google's as part of broader Alphabet, focusing on the life sciences arm of things. And so it was really Verily was focusing on leveraging miniaturized sensors, advanced technology, machine learning in applications around health and disease. And so I joined as a product manager for Verily first. And having, you know, dabbled in a variety of complex wearables from more regulated medical devices like diabetic pumps to baby care devices to then software applications. And now I'm here.
Yeah, at first I thought maybe there isn't such a link between biomedical engineering and Verily and Pixel Buds. But now that you mention algorithms and miniature hardware, kind of makes sense suddenly.
Definitely. And all around the wearable space as well.
Exactly. So you joined a team behind Pixel Buds. Do you have any special appreciation for music or sound in general? Is that even required to work on the Pixel Buds team?
Well, I definitely like music. And if you ever were to borrow my Spotify or Pandora playlist, you'll see I have a typical 90s millennial soundtrack. But I'm by no means an audio expert. I think I bring two key things to the role, which is one, a passion for being able to identify true user problems and solving them. And then two, just leveraging my background both on the consumer wearable space, but also in software to bring these experiences together. As you know, all great products have both hardware and software.
Absolutely. So today we're talking about Pixel Buds 2A. They're succeeding the pretty cool Pixel Buds A series. So what's there to improve? Because they were great. How do you design a successor and how do you sort of decide where to go next from your perspective?
That's a great question. I think we started with, first and foremost, our customer, our users of the first generation Pixel Buds A series, and really tried to listen to them and understand what were their top pain points from using the first gen product. And the top areas that they gave feedback on was, first and foremost, not having active noise cancellation, giving them the chance to focus, have that immersive sound quality. The second was around, they thought the battery life wasn't particularly exceptional. And then the third was just overall sound quality. And we really think that we're trying to really meet users where they're at with their complaints. And so with the Pixel Buds 2A, the first thing we came with is active noise cancellation, addressing their top need. And it's not just checkbox active noise cancellation. It's really delivering pro-level active noise cancellation to our users, giving them that chance of focus and being in that flow state so that they can better enjoy their music wherever they're at.
That's great. But it also sounds sort of complicated, right? Because adding active noise cancellation, and I read, you know, in our press releases, we say it's better than the active noise cancellation we had in the original Pixel Buds Pro. And then, of course, you need to ensure that Pixel Buds 2A holds that sort of value promise as well, right? So how do you have all these factors together and then still do a good job? That seems pretty tough.
Yeah, so we really feel good about the active noise cancellation that's coming with these Pixel Buds 2A. It's in fact, with the Silent Seal 1.5, it's actually 1.5 times stronger active noise cancellation than our first generation Pixel Buds Pro. And this is all because it comes with the Tensor A1 chip. It's powered by the Tensor A1 chip that provides more advanced audio processing. And it also delivers more effective real-time noise cancellation.
Amazing. So that'll be great. Well, you mentioned three things that you wanted to improve. So maybe we can walk down the list. Second thing you mentioned, battery life. How do you improve battery life on wearables like this? I mean, is it just a matter of a bigger battery or is it not that simple?
Couple things to extend the battery life. So, you know, it kind of goes back to our Tensor A1 chip. It allows us to do audio processing with greater power efficiency. And so we can do more with less. I think the other thing is, like, we're very proud of our Pixel Buds 2A case. You know, it is a smaller, more pocketable case that can more easily fit snugly into your clutch or the back of your pant pocket. But it's really a more capable case that comes with a better battery life than our first generation A series. In fact, it's 7 hours on your buds with ANC on, 10 hours with ANC off, compared to the 5 hours without ANC on our first generation Pixel Buds A series. So it's essentially doubling the buds runtime so that you can have a greater peace of mind as you wear your buds throughout the day.
That's an amazing improvement. And we need to talk about a case a little bit later because there's more to it than meets the eye. But let's talk about the third thing you mentioned, sound quality. That seems so difficult to me because, well, again, you cannot make these things $1,000, right? You need to make sure that it sounds great for the price. And then every other person has a different sound preference. So how do you cater for all these preferences and make sure everyone thinks it has great sound?
I think at the core of Pixel Buds 2A is really focusing on the essentials that users care about. And so we really tried to prioritize the high impact features that matter most to our users while trading off some of the, you know, more premium, less essential features that can help bring the price point down for our users. And so, you know, for example, I mean, when we talk about sound quality, powered by the Tensor A1 chip, it gives you that immersive sound quality and noise cancellation. It also gives you the improved transparency mode that didn't exist before, allowing you to still keep your buds in your ears while allowing your important environmental sounds to pass through. This is particularly important if you're, you know, walking in the streets and you want to note if a bus or bike is passing by, if the traffic lights are changing. You want to be aware of and stay maximally aware of those surroundings. And so having the ANC combined with the transparency mode is important. The other piece is our buds come with custom design 11 millimeter speaker drivers. And so it gives you that better sound quality. It also comes with a 5-band personalizable EQ. So users can turn up the bass, better customize their sound to their preference.
And of course they need to fit comfortably. Is there a change in Pixel Buds 2A compared to the original A series?
Definitely. So our Pixel Buds 2A come with a twist to adjust stabilizer that's, you know, inspired by the design of our Pixel Buds Pro 2 that were launched last year. And, you know, at the end of the day, we understand that users' ears are all different, but it's a static design is very challenging to meet everyone's needs. And so this twist to adjust stabilizer really allows for the customization that users need. So if you want to sit back, relax, watch a show, you can wear the buds in a looser, more comfortable fit. But if you want to head out for your daily commute, go for a jog, you can do a quick twist to really dial in for a more secure fit.
So I'm wondering where you are on this and the team. I know there's an increasing number of people who like wearing their earbuds throughout the day, even if maybe they're not turned on. Is that you? Is that the team? Do you see those differences as well?
Yeah. So, you know, I think with earbuds fitting, you know, most users expect it to work out of the box. It's a non-negotiable. But like I said, I think customization is key here. So one of the things that I've learned to do and also push others wearing earbuds is really to try those ear tips that come with the earbuds out of the box. For me, I was surprised to find that on my left ear, I have to use a small ear tip. And on my right, I an extra small ear tip fits me best.
And
And so having this personalized ear tip sizes, along with dialing and using the twist to adjust stabilizer, I'm now able to go on jogs and even do some jumping jacks with my earbuds.
Well, you have the case in your hand. We definitely need to talk about the case for a minute. So I think one of the amazing things, you know, with Pixel 10, we're on a journey on making things more repairable, replaceable anyway. And I was so surprised. It was so cool to find out that now the battery inside the case is replaceable. So what was that journey of deciding that and then also to actually make that happen?
Yeah, you're absolutely right, Rachid. So when we really think about long-term value, repairability is key. And we didn't want to design something that user just hands off to repair centers. In particular, for the Pixel Buds 2A, we had the working team come in and attempt a battery repair process with readily off-the-shelf tools and a repair manual that we had designed in-house. And we asked them to understand what it's like and all the pain points that users might have to go through the process. They timed their experience and then gave us the feedback. And I think what we learned coming out of this study was something that is small but very important, is we added a pull tab to the case battery so that it's easier for users to remove the case battery during repair. This shaved off minutes off the repair process. And another thing we did was we made this pull tab a spearmint color. And it's not just about color. It's really around providing a sustainability, repairability theme across all of our repairable components in the Pixel portfolio. And so it's really being a very visible, deliberate signpost for users to recognize, hey, that's a component I can engage with during the repair process, making the entire procedure much more recognizable, faster, and easier for both users and technicians.
That's a great repairability tip. So you're saying that not only in the case of Pixel Buds 2A, but also in other Pixel 10 devices, if there's something I want to remove, I need to sort of find the spearmint thing and then pull it.
That's correct.
That is really nice. And, you know, I'm not the most handy person in the world. I'm more of a software person than a hardware person. Can I still replace the battery myself, you think?
You should definitely give it a try. Maybe you don't even need tools with this near spearmint pull tab.
Amazing. Now, there's something that confused me a little bit. Maybe you can help me clear this up. I know that the new Pixel Buds 2A have support for the Find Hub that we have now in Android 16, but there's no little speaker on the case, which is on the Pixel Buds Pro 2's case, right? So how do I find my case if it doesn't have a speaker?
Yeah, that's a great question. So, you know, for us, you know, to meet that compelling price point, we had to make some smart hardware trade-offs in the Pixel Buds 2A. And so with that, as you said, Rachid, it doesn't have a speaker in the charging case. We know that users would be very frustrated if they lost their entire system. And so what we did was we actually tested a scenario where it's, if the case was misplaced with the earbud still in the case, is there still a way to recover the system? And so we came up with a pretty clever solution and using software to address this hardware gap. What that does is when the system knows that the earbuds are in the case, it's able to ring the earbuds loudly so that when the case is within ringing distance, even with the lid closed, users can still ring their earbuds and hear the entire system and have a way to retrieve it. And so this is just an example of a simple yet elegant solution to address a necessary trade-off.
Vanessa, I guess almost every Google product uses AI to make stuff better. So what's the AI in Pixel Buds 2A and what does it help achieve?
Yeah, so our Pixel Buds 2A actually have AI and machine learning integrated within it, but it's for two particular use cases that I want to highlight. One is around a wind model that is able to suppress wind noise. And then the other one is a voice call model that helps isolate your voice so you can sound clear for the person on the other line. And so In isolation, they both work wonderfully. But together, that's kind of when the real magic happens. You are outdoors, the wind gusts, and you're trying to join a phone call and have a conversation with someone else on the other line. And, you know, the wind detection and suppression model kicks in, and it's able to detect wind or any turbulence, and it's able to still pass through the type of noise, the type of sound that matters to you, whether it's the person on the other call or whatever media you're listening to. Then there's a second voice call model that then isolates your voice so that you can sound clearer to the other person on the call.
So this season, we're answering questions from our Pixel superfans community, and we got a great question from Taylor. And the question, it's a bit of a long one, but it boils down to this. Do large companies at some point have to stop catering to power users, or can you find a balance with, I guess, regular users? I think that's a great question, you know, to ask someone who's working on hearables and wearables. It's probably not easy to strike a balance.
Yeah, well, first of all, thank you for the question, Taylor. But, you know, I really hope that we have what you need, whether you are a power user or a non-power user. If you're looking for the latest, the greatest, the best features that you can get with Pixel Buds, we have our Pixel Buds Pro 2 that recently launched in the new Moonstone color, but it also comes with a software update that gives you better interactions with Gemini, adaptive audio, loud sound protection, head gestures to more easily accept or decline calls. Now, if you're not a power user and you're just looking for the essentials, the fundamentals of Pixel Buds, Pixel Buds 2A is the answer. You know, it comes with all of the essentials in terms of a peace of mind battery life, pro-level active noise cancellation, great sound quality.
Now, as we're recording this, it's about 2 weeks before Pixel Buds 2A go on sale. I'm wondering, where will you be when it launches and what will you be doing? Are you like refreshing every page with a review, see what people think? Or I'm just curious, like what's the state of mind by then?
I think I will definitely be celebrating with the team. We are just so proud of everything that we've accomplished in the small set of earbuds. It's Pixel Buds 2A is really a culmination of hard work, dedication, user focus, problem solving, you know, across our hardware, software, UX, design, business sales, marketing teams. And so just very proud of what we've accomplished. But for me personally, of course, I will also be tuning in to, you know, the reviews, the user feedback, and just really hear what we got right and also areas that we can further improve. And as you said it before, in Pixel, we constantly look for ways to improve the product. And so we'll definitely be tuning in on areas where we can further improve in future releases.
Amazing. Vanessa, thank you so much for bringing us Pixel Buds 2A. If you want a pair, go to store.google.com and find them there or in any other retailer that carries them. And, well, congratulations on them, Vanessa, and hope to have you in a future episode of the Made by Google podcast. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Rachid.
Thank you for listening to the Made by Google podcast. Don't miss out on new episodes. Subscribe now wherever you get your podcasts to be the first to listen.